So final accounts consists of financial statements, preparation of financial statements, and already discussed financial statements are income statement, and you have your position statement. The second one is, it involves preparation of position statement. So this income statement or position statement are the modern names given to what we traditionally call trading and P&L account. Traditionally, income statement is called as trading and P&L account, and the modern version of what we call position statement is traditionally called as balance sheet. Sometimes you have an extra account called manufacturing account if you are preparing your final accounts of a manufacturing concern. What is a manufacturing concern? Which converts raw material into finished product. So if it is a manufacturing concern, the income statement would consist of manufacturing account, trading account, and P&L account. Now we see that these are the accounts that has to be prepared. Now how do we relate the concepts just now or previously we discussed what we said as capital expenditure, revenue expenditure, deferred revenue expenditure, or what we said capital income, deferred revenue income. So let us see how we say, when we say capital items, in capital items we had capital expenditure and we had capital income. Now then when we said we have revenue items, in revenue items again we had revenue expenditure, revenue incomes, or simply revenues we say. Then we had deferred items. In deferred items, again we had deferred incomes, revenue incomes rather, then deferred revenue expenditure. Now these are the concepts we have discussed previously. Now how these are related to this income statement and position statement we will discuss. Now if you see, if it is a capital expenditure, remember you will be taking it in balance sheet, you will be taking in balance sheet on what we say asset side. So balance sheet usually has two sides, asset side and liability side. It is balance sheet is based on your accounting equation. So in balance sheet we will be taking all the examples of capital expenditure on asset side. Similarly, capital incomes are taken in balance sheet on what we say liability side. On liability side we'll be taking all your capital incomes. Now coming to revenue items, when it is a revenue expenditure, rather we use the word expenses. Revenue expenses we will be taking in manufacturing or trading or P&L account debit side, because you know the rule, debit all expenses and losses. So when it is a revenue income, usually it is taken in trading account or P&L account on credit side. Now coming to deferred items, we will be taking deferred revenue incomes in balance sheet on liability side, Similarly, deferred revenue expenses in balance sheet on asset side. So you have to remember these important points before preparation of final accounts.